At 5:30 p.m. in Tuscaloosa yesterday, Governor George Wallace's defiance of a federal court order to integrate the University of Alabama crumbled when he was confronted by federalized National Guard troops. Two Negro students, James Hood and Vivian Malone, both 20, enrolled shortly thereafter. There was no violence, but the governor, standing at the schoolhouse door as promised, did not make the process easy. Earlier, at 1 p.m., Mr. Wallace had refused a personal request by Deputy Attorney General Nicholas Katzenbach that he allow the two students to enter Foster Auditorium and register. Governor Wallace, flanked by state troopers, replied to Mr. Katzenbach's request with a statement.
As governor and chief magistrate of the state of Alabama, I deem it to be my solemn obligation and duty to stand before you, representing the rights and sovereignty of this state and its peoples. The unwelcomed, unwanted, unwarranted, and force-induced intrusion upon the campus of the University of Alabama, today of the might of the central government, offers frightful example of the oppression of the rights, privileges, and sovereignty of this state by officers of the federal government. Now, therefore, I, George C. Wallace, as governor of the state of Alabama, do hereby denounce and forbid this illegal and unwarranted action by the central government.
Mr. Katzenbach, who was accompanied by two federal marshals, responded to the governor's statement.
I take it from that statement that you are going to stand in that door and that you are not going to carry out the orders of this court, and that you are going to resist us from doing so. Is that correct?
I stand upon the statement.
Stand upon that statement. Governor, I'm not interested in a show. I don't know what the purpose of the show is. I am interested in the orders of these courts being enforced. I would ask you once again to responsibly step aside, and if you do not, I'm going to assure you that the orders of those courts will be enforced. Two students who simply seek an education on this campus are presently on the campus. They have a right to be here, protected by that court order. They have a right to register here, and those students who remain on this campus, they will register today, and they will go to school at this university at this summer session. The university has indicated its willingness to accept them. From the outset, Governor, all of us have known that the final chapter of this would be the admission of these students. I ask you once again to reconsider the consequences of your statement, and I'll ask you once again, will you give me the assurance that you will step aside and peacefully do your duty?
Governor Wallace did not step aside. Mr. Katzenbach did not bring Mr. Hood and Miss Malone, who were waiting in a nearby car, to confront the governor. Instead, the two students were taken directly to their dormitories. Mr. Katzenbach then called President Kennedy to inform him that Governor Wallace, as expected, had ignored the president's cease and desist order contained within a presidential proclamation issued last week because the proclamation had no legal force. After the call, President Kennedy issued an executive order, which had already been prepared, authorizing the federalization of the Alabama National Guard under the Insurrection Act of 1807. At 5:30, Major General Henry Graham, in command of the federalized guardsmen, approached and saluted Governor Wallace, who had remained at Foster Auditorium. The general said, quote, "Sir, it is my sad duty to ask you to step aside under the orders of the President of the United States," unquote. Before complying, Governor Wallace issued a final statement.
We are winning in this fight because we are awakening the American people to the dangers that we have spoken about so many times, which is so evident today, the trend toward military dictatorship in this country. We shall now return to Montgomery for the purpose of continuing this fight because we are winning. We shall continue to work for a better Alabama, for all the people of this state, both white and Negro. And it is my prayer that God above shall bless all the people of this state, both white and black.
A short time later, the newly registered Vivian Malone was asked for a statement on the day's events.
Well, I would just like to say that I'm glad that the registration is over and everything is over now. I think we can get down to studying. This is our main purpose here, and I'm glad that it has all been over now, and all we have to do now is go get our books and start studying. That's all.